Hey, what is happening? This is Lionel, you're watching TechLine, and this is the Poco F2 Pro. With the recent price drops, you can get this phone for just about $400. Yes, but for this amount of money, you're getting a Snapdragon 865 processor, other great specifications, a triple camera setup, and a lot more other features. In my long-term review, I wanted to mention how the phone held up over time, what I love about the device, and the key shortcomings. Let me start talking about what I love about this phone. We have killer specifications that translate to great overall performance, both when it comes to gaming and the day-to-day usage. A Snapdragon 865 CPU combined with a dedicated gaming mode assures that the latest 3D games just fly on highest graphics settings. From PUBG to Call of Duty Mobile, this phone has you covered. MIUI, you either love it or hate it, but either way, the phone has a lot of features and customization options, and most importantly, it feels fast and smooth. The MIUI 12 looks nice and clean, and I love that there are quite a few customization options, just like we're all used to seeing on any Xiaomi device. The 12th version of the MIUI is the most favorite yet, both in terms of speed and the overall feature set. When it comes to build quality, the Poco F2 Pro is really solid. It actually looks and feels like a legit flagship device. It really depends on how you treat your phone, but my unit still looks pretty much new, even though there are a few scratches on their pre-installed screen protector and a shiny and glossy backplate. The display is really nice, it is sharp, and the colors are accurate. It is also very bright, so it can be easily viewable outdoors. The under-display fingerprint scanner has been consistently accurate, even though you need to press and hold your finger a bit longer than on flagship devices. Face unlock feature has been consistently accurate. The motorized pop-up mechanism that houses a 20-megapixel selfie shooter works as new, and the LED lights around it look pretty cool. If you go to the settings menu, you can even customize these LED lights. Since I only use Bluetooth earphones now, I never use the headphone jack, but it's still nice to see this feature. The buttons are comfortable to reach and they are still clicky and responsive. I didn't miss a stereo speaker setup on this phone because a bottom-firing loudspeaker is really good. The Poco F2 Pro received quite a few software updates that improved the overall camera performance. We have a quad camera system that consists of wide, ultra-wide, macro, and depth sensors, but however, there is no optical zoom lens, which is one of the key shortcomings of this device. I wouldn't say that the Poco F2 Pro's cameras produce flagship-grade quality images, but the overall picture quality is one of the best in this price segment. The majority of images have nice color reproduction, even though a bit on the saturated side. The photos also have good sharpness and a high amount of detail. A 64-megapixel mode gives you even more detail, but I would stick to a standard auto mode for a more consistent camera performance. The portraits also look nice with accurate object separation from the background and beautiful skin tones. Selfie portraits look really good thanks to that beefy 20-megapixel sensor. The pictures look very nice and sharp not only on social media but also on a larger screen. A dedicated telephoto macro shooter produces nice-looking close-up shots, but honestly, it's not my style of photography, so I didn't use it a lot. In low light, I suggest you use a dedicated night mode that produces really nice looking images. Pictures taken in auto or 64 megapixel modes do not impress, and the wide angle shooter is not great at all. Just stick to the main shooter at night. Low light selfie quality is quite decent if you have at least a little bit of fill light. There are plenty of video recording options on this phone, and you can go up to 8K 30fps resolution if you need a lot of detail, or choose 4K 60fps for both detail and extra frame rate. However, I mostly used 4K 30fps mode that produces really nice, sharp, and most importantly, stable and smooth video. A stock camera app also allows you to switch between the main and wide-angle shooters while you are recording the video. There's a steady video mode too that offers near gimbal-like stabilization, but it's limited to 1080p, so I stick to 4K for extra detail, and stabilization is good enough for me. Where I miss good stabilization is video produced with a selfie camera. The footage looks nice overall, but it could be more stable. The battery life has been really good on this device thanks to a massive 4700 mAh unit. On average, I could get over 8 hours of screen on time. If you use the phone mostly for YouTube videos on about 50% of screen brightness setting, you can get over 16 hours of SOT, which is a really impressive result. The included 33W power delivery 3.0 compliant charger is able to charge the phone in just about 65 minutes, which is a pretty impressive result for a handset carrying a 4700 mAh battery. The retail packaging also includes a high-quality silicone case to protect your phone. Connectivity has been great on this device, including call quality, signal reception, Wi-Fi, and GPS. There is also NFC on board. Now the shortcomings section. There is no IP68 certification for water and dust resistance, but that might be too much to ask considering the price of the phone. Other cons: no microSD card slot for storage expansion, no optical zoom lens, and no video stabilization in 4K 60fps using the main camera, and no video stabilization in 1080p using the selfie shooter. So here's my conclusion. Despite a few caveats, the Poco F2 Pro is a really solid device. In fact, I think this is one of the top phones you can buy considering the price of just about 400 bucks, because you're getting flagship-grade specifications, great design, a really good quad camera system, stellar battery life, and a lot more other features. Therefore, I can easily say that the Poco F2 Pro is one of the best phones for the price of just about 400 bucks. What do you think about the Poco F2 Pro? Would you buy this phone or would you choose another option? As always, like the video if you liked it, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, follow me on social media, and as always, it was Linus, thank you for watching, and see you soon.